Another one of Jarrah's rather absurd claims is that only a handful of geologists have ever looked at NASA's moon rocks.
Let's hear it one more time.
Hundreds of other geologists have examined these rocks.
This is simply false. In actuality, out of all the thousands and thousands of geologists within the scientific community, only a tiny handful has physically studied the lunar material. As Space.com reported on May 23rd, 2000, about 40 or 50 scientists around the world are still investigating the moon rocks. They have to apply to the curators at the Johnson Space Center with a detailed explanation on how they plan to use the samples and what they hope to learn. Graham Ryder and Callum McAllister are just two out of a tiny few who have actually examined the moon rocks for themselves. Needless to say, with as little as 50 out of the world's entire population examining moon rocks, it comes as no surprise to me why there is seldom any mention, if ever, of oxidation and water being found in the moon rocks.
The operative word in the Space.com article is still. 40 to 50 scientists were still studying the moon rocks in May of 2000 when this article was written. If Jarrah is correct, and only 40 or 50 scientists have ever looked at NASA's moon rocks over the past 40 years, then I suppose von Braun was lying when he wrote in this popular science article that 142 investigators were busy studying the first moon samples brought back by the Apollo 11 astronauts and were preparing reports for the first lunar science conference in January 1970. And the 379 independent scientists and research labs listed here who authored or co-authored 139 different papers between 1970 and 1975 alone must have lied about all the testing they performed on those moon rocks. I suppose Jarrah thinks that none of them really investigated the mineralogy, chemistry, and petrology of these rocks. None of them compared these rocks to Earth rocks, noting the similarities and differences. No one really marveled at the unusual combinations of rare earth elements in the creep rocks, or identified minerals, such as armalcolite, not known to exist on Earth at the time. None of them did any radiometric testing and discovered that all NASA's moon rocks were as old as, or older than, the oldest Earth rocks known to exist at the time, and that they had cosmic ray exposure ages as old as ancient meteorites, known to originate from deep space. And the NASA curate must be lying about sending out 400 samples each year to scientists and educators all over the world. All you have to do is take a simple training class on how to handle moon rocks. Once you're certified, you just make out a request and voila, you get your moon rocks. That is, if you're a scientist or educator. It's not that difficult for an ordinary geologist to get their hands on a genuine moon rock. All they need is a reason to study it. In 2010, more than 40 years after the Apollo missions, the third generation of geologists and scientists are now studying the lunar samples brought back by those astronauts. Are they all in on the hoax too? New tests and new data are being produced regularly. Is all this data the result of stupid scientists studying bogus moon rocks? Or are all the scientists just lying? Saying that only 40 or 50 scientists have ever looked at NASA's moon rocks, while knowing that the number is probably well over 1,000, Jarrah has perpetrated yet another fallacy of proportion. Ciao, moon hoax conspirators, wherever you are.